The following film contains scenes of a sexual nature and strong language throughout. Viewer discretion is advised.
Shake that money on a dime. Don't be a sugar daddy, she can work it just fine. Up on the table, she'll be dancing all night.
Where did the idea of becoming a drag queen start?
It had been years ago. I used to have a partner who used to be a singer, and he used to go around working men's clubs and do that, and then I used to go with him, and then I decided, well, I want to get on stage as well. And we tried it a few times in a few clubs. It was a massive disaster. It was horrible. And it kind of got buried for a little bit longer, like another year or so. And then I went to work in a gay bar in Wakefield at New Union. And there, we needed something different. We had DJs on, we had karaoke, we had everything else, but we needed something different. So we sat down one night at 4 a.m. on a Saturday, all smashed out of our face on brandy and wine. And we went, well, what are we going to do? Well, I wore a dress once, and I went around working men's clubs.
His own special dream, and that dream's just about to come true. Life's not as bad as it may seem if you open your eyes to what's in front of you.
Be a dreamer,
dreamer.
Boys will make you happy.
Sordid and the Paradise Showgirls perform every Saturday at the Pink Pony Club in York. We were lucky enough to get pre-show interview with the girls before their big show.
How long does it usually take you to get ready?
About 2 minutes, I'm ready now. I'm going now. Hello, we're ready, showtime. Pass me my tits.
About an hour, doesn't it?
Wow.
It depends if that's the makeup going natural or not.
Depending on what mood you're in, I can be out front in 20 minutes. But normally about an hour. About half an hour for your makeup, 20 minutes to get your dress on, and then 10 minutes pissing about where you leave.
I mean, add stuff to it. I mean, there are people who genuinely think I get up on the morning, and the first thing I do is get out of bed, put my tights on, paint a face, put a wig on, and then go, right, what do I need to do today? Well, I'll go down to Tesco's and get some beans, and then I'll go see my nan and do all that sort of stuff. And we don't, it's a job. That's it. Some people, in the words of Miss Jason, when she did an interview a few years back down in Brighton, she went, it's a job, and it's a job I feel the need to do. Some people are vicars, some people are policemen, some people are firemen. I'm a drag queen and it's no different. All I'm doing is a job to earn a living. It comes off when the pay stops, it goes into a bag, and then I continue my life as me.
Obviously, I'd say your partners in Paradise, Lexi and Cherry. Where did they come into it?
Cherry, I've quite lucky because again I got to choose my own team. Cherry's from the Viaduct Show Bar in Leeds, and she used to be a showgirl for them, which is why I wanted to give her a job, because she could bring insight from that. So she got the DJing job, and then I was very, very lucky because Lexi's been around for a few years. I'll be careful because she'll hit me.
How long have you been a drag queen for, Lexi?
When was God's dog a puppy?
I am the original snake in the Garden of Eden, dear. Been at it about nearly 20 years, on and off.
She's been around for like 20 years. She's a trained choreographer and dancer. She's
been there and done everything. She's worked abroad, she's worked at the Birdcage in Manchester, she was the lead there. So when she heard about this and she messaged me saying, oh, if you want any help, let me know. And I literally ripped her hand off and went, come and give me an hand with this. And I've never looked back, she's a star. She's much more talented than I am. She really is. She can do a lot more than I can, but she's been going a lot longer.
To lighten things up a bit, let's talk costume, because they are
outfits. I spend far too much on outfits.
They are quite glamorous, I must say. And I remember one thing where you sat there, and I'll tell you this myself, when we first went in the pink pony, sat with my friends, and I've honestly seen women less pretty than you look when you're all in that glam. So yeah, talk about the costumes, because they are incredible.
I think it all depends on what style you want to go. Cherry's style is very different to mine. She wants much more of a natural woman kind of style, where I'm going for the very old style drag, where it's big glam, it's big feathers, it's massive jewellery, it's the long dresses. And they cost a lot of money to have made, but to me they're beautiful. And when you get under a spotlight and it sparkles. So I think when you're going to go see a show, and you want to see something that's more than what you see every day. You want to stand there and be like, oh, that's amazing, I don't know how they look like that, I don't know how they do this. And it's all part of the package. If you've got your fantastic costumes, you've got the banter, you've got everything else, it gives them an amazing experience all around.
Has anyone actually ever mistakenly come up to you as thinking you were a girl? Like a straight guy?
Happens all the time. And God knows where they get these things. Because if I saw a girl walking down the street that looked like me, look, I'd be like, there's something wrong with her.
I think it's because you made her so naturally sassy.
Maybe I'm just a repressed female, who knows?
What's their usual reaction when you tell them?
I like to not leave them on as far as I can.
Get a couple of drinks out.
Yeah, get a few
first.
Drinks.
Get some drinks down them.
And they stopped at the toilet and then you nip down the fire escape and job's good.
Yeah, when they go for a grab.
I just don't know. They can't tell. Like, oh, you're well fit, you are. But I'd love to take you home and shag you. I'm like, y'all look like they're fucking sorry at morning love, not me.
My husband came on Friday with a brand new motor car. He told me I could drive it. I said, Brian, you're a star. We drove down to the boozer for a vodka and a fag. Then, of course, we had to celebrate the purchase with a shag. We go dogging. We go dogging. We're a treat for any passers-by out jogging. We do it because we found that when people crowd around, it is somehow more profound when you're dogging.
Do you think this drag queen career is going to be for the long haul, or...?
For me, it is. There's some that do a couple of years. But for me, I know when I'm 40, 50, 60 years old, I'll still be doing this because it's something that I enjoy. I don't see it as a job. I really don't. It's something which I get so much pleasure out of. I meet so many amazing people, and I get to help quite a lot of people because people, again, when you're a drag queen, the younger ones that do come out, you can take them under the wing. And people do come to you with their problems as well, because obviously being around on a lot of scenes, we see a lot and help a lot. So it's nice to give things back. So I'd like to still be around in 60 years so I can still pass on my advice to people. And it's just good fun. I'll obviously have to have panels put in my costumes because they won't fit me because I'll be a fat bugger by then. But my costumes will become sleeves. But yeah, I want to do it. I mean, eventually my grand plan is to keep going, save enough money, and then I want to get my own bar for a couple of years. I want to go work abroad for a little bit and then come back eventually. I want to retire down in Brighton. I don't want a big showy bar, I just want a nice little bar that ticks over. And to be quite honest, I'm going to sit at the end of it and drink myself into an early grave, happy as a pig in poo.
To the end.
Has your partner ever gone down the drag?
Gone down quite a few times.